So I just want to start off with a small joke about an imam who had two young children. And he came in for Friday khutbah. And as before he started, he told his two kids to be absolutely silent. And then he wanted to make sure that they understood, so he asked, why do you think you have to be silent during the khutbah? So one of the kids, he jumped up and said, because everybody's sleeping. So I hope that's, alhamdulillah, I hope that is not the case at JMIC. JMIC, every time I come here, I see everyone is very alive, mashallah. So even though it's tiring after a long day, I'd like to share with you a few things that are very important. Last year, I shared this with my congregation in the Bronx, and I had amazing feedback afterwards. So the first thing I would like to share with you is a hadith from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he said, he asked his companions, he said, أَتَدْرُونَ مَا الْمُفْلِسِ. Do you know the person who is bankrupt? Do you know who can tell me, just raise your hand, say who is some, how do you identify someone to be bankrupt? Anyone? Come on, you guys know the word, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna pick on someone. Alright, you. Who's bankrupt?
The person who has what?
The, no, no, I'm talking about in regular sense, yeah, bankruptcy. Who's bankrupt? Yeah. A
homeless person?
I mean, a wealthy person can also file bankruptcy, so he can actually technically be bankrupt, but he may have a mansion, he may have a car. So bankruptcy, a bankrupt person is someone who has a lot of debt, but he doesn't have any asset to pay off that debt. Does that make sense? So all of these assets go against that the huge debt that he has. So the companions, they answered similarly. They said, well, among us, the one who is bankrupt is someone who has no dinar and no dirham, someone who has no money. But the Prophet ﷺ said, rather, the one who is bankrupt amongst my ummah is the one who will come on the day of judgment with salah, with siyam, with zakah. Remember, what with three things he said, right? With prayer, with fasting, and with charity. But he would have insulted this person, slandered that person, consumed the wealth of this person, shed the blood of that person, and beaten this person. And all of whom, all of their hasanat, all of his hasanat will go to them. And if his hasanat runs out, their sins will be put on him. And then he will be cast into the hellfire. This is narrated by Muslim. This, the hadith that I mentioned, this is in Sahih Muslim number 2581, if you're interested in looking it up. Do you guys realize what just happened? Someone who is praying, someone who is fasting, someone who is taking care of his zakah. A lot of us will do that, right, in Ramadan. But that person slandered and backbited and beaten someone, took the right of other people on the day of judgment, it will be a scary situation for him. Do we have people like this? Do we have such bankrupt people amongst us? Unfortunately, we do. Almost every community, we have people like. So they will say, oh, did you hear what this person said? And then he will tell the second brother. And then the second brother will tell the third brother. And by the time he reaches the fifth brother, he'll start actually believing what is being said. So that is why this is something that we have to be very careful about. Okay. I forgot to bring chocolates, but this is a chocolate question, okay? Alright. Raise your hand if you can answer this. Tell me the difference between ghiba, buhtan, and namima. I know you guys have heard these words before, right? You know what ghiba is? What is the English word for ghiba? Backbiting, right? What is the English word for buhtan? Slander, right? What's the word for namima? Rumor spreading, gossip, someone who's spreading gossip. So here are the differences. Ghiba, backbiting, is something that you say about someone in their absence, right? Which they would like you to say. Is it true or false? When you backbite about someone, whatever you say, is it right or wrong? It's true. It's true, and you say it, that's backbiting. When you say it's false, that's what? That's slander. And the namima, the gossiping is someone, you hear news about someone, hey, you know, did you see that sister over there? Oh my God. And then you tell it to this person and this person. So you hear some kind of private information about someone, and you spread it around. What is your goal? To cause conflict between those people, to harm them. So that would be gossip. So the Prophet ﷺ, he mentioned this very explicitly. He said that the honor, the blood, and the wealth of a Muslim is sacred. Three things: our blood, our wealth, and our honor. Alhamdulillah, I'm sure over here we don't shed anyone's blood. We usually, alhamdulillah, most people, we don't, you know, budge into other people's wealth. But a lot of us, we are not careful about other people's honor. So, inshallah, I'll be doing this in a few segments. So, I have about 4 minutes left. I'd like to share with you two reasons why this is such an important thing. The first thing you should be aware of is that if you are fasting this long summer days, it's a lot of effort. All of those efforts will be for nothing. You will get only hunger out of your fast if you are involved in this. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, رُبَّ صَائِمٍ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ صِيَامِهِ إِلَّا الْجُوعِ. There may be a fasting person who will get nothing out of his fasting except hunger. So the only thing at the end of the day you will get is hunger. You will not get any reward for that. Why? Because of someone who does not give up false speech. Someone who does not give up acting upon it. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, he said that fasting is not just giving up food and drink, rather it is giving up lying, falsehood, and idle chit-chat. That's what fasting is. Hafsa bint Sirin, she said that fasting is a shield. Do you guys know a shield? You know, in the Avengers, if you've seen the shield, right, that comes to your mind, right? It's a shield, it's a very strong shield. So long as the one who fasts does not break it. And what breaks that shield is backbiting. So that's the first reason. We should be very careful about dishonoring our Muslim brother or sister while we are fasting. I'm not talking about just during the daytime while you're actually hungry. No, I'm talking about even now. Second reason, the one who does this will be punished in the grave. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam once passed by one of the gardens of Medina, and he heard the sound of two people being punished in the grave. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, they're being punished. They're not being punished for something major. Something very difficult they could not avoid. They're being punished for something that they could avoid. One of them is being punished because he was not protecting himself. He didn't protect himself from urine. So when he did number one, he wasn't careful about it. Second person was being punished because he would walk around spreading gossip. So when you hear someone, hey brother, come here. I got something really juicy to tell you. Hey, did you hear that, brother? What are you supposed to say? Tell me. They say, stop. But do you know this for a fact? Mind your own business. Inshallah, I'll talk about mind your own business. It is a concept from Islam. Minding your own business, there is a hadith that proves that concept. So then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took two palm leaves, and you know the rest of the story. So nowadays, we have dollars. The currency we have is, in America, it's dollars, right? That's the currency. But a day will come when that currency will be invalid. It will have no use. So on that day, think about it. Just think about it. Your entire life, you've been praying, you've been fasting, you've been taking care of your zakat, but you've been also gossiping about others, backbiting others, slandering others. All of your good deeds will be for nothing. And worst case scenario, your good deeds will go to those people that you have backbited and slandered about. And if your good deeds run out, what's next? Who can tell me? Their sins will be put on you to the point it will be so heavy, you'll end up in the hellfire. Subhanallah, think about it. That's a scary thought. So my dear brothers and sisters, inshallah, we'll continue this in the next segment. But I wanted to share this with you that all the hard work that we are putting into this Ramadan, let's not Do not let this go to waste. Do not let this go to waste. I know, you know, alhamdulillah, after iftar, you know, we just sit around chatting. Make sure that we protect our tongue. Make sure that we protect our tongue. This goes for everyone. This goes for our youngsters as well, and for our elders, for the brothers and for the sisters. And we should tell our family members, especially in this month of Ramadan, make it a habit. If someone comes to you with something they want to say, something juicy, something gossipy, let's say that, you know, leave me alone. Don't bother me with it. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our hearts. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of our deeds with sincerity. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all of our sins. And at the end of this Ramadan, let us start off with a blank slate. Subhanallah wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.